visible light 400 nanometers, 50 nanometers, something. That problem. Good morning, Junaid. Students, formulas very important to solve these problems. May you know what is the relation between wavelength and frequency? Wavelength to frequency, nu is equal to c by lambda, or lambda is equal to c by nu. This formula is very very important. Okay, na? Wavelength to frequency are inversely proportional or directly proportional?
Yes.
Students, wavelength and frequency are
inversely proportional.
That is important, ma. So some relations I will ask later. You have to say, okay, na? Suppose inversely proportional you are telling. I am comparing two bodies wavelengths and two bodies frequencies. Lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to, with respect to frequency, what can I write? I am taking one body wavelength frequency, another body wavelength frequency. Lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to this is wavelength. Frequency, how can I write?
Frequency 2 by frequency 1.
Frequency 2 by, very good. Frequency 2 by frequency 1, very good. So lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to nu 2 by nu 1. Inversely proportional, alva. So that's why like that we calculate. Suppose energy wavelength inversely proportional. Ma. E1 by E2 is equal to what we can write? Inversely proportional, you are telling energy and wavelength. So E1 by E2 means what we can write? Lambda 1 by lambda 2 or lambda 2 by lambda 1?
Lambda 2 by lambda 1.
These formulas are important, ma. So you have to frame your own whenever in the examination different types of questions they may ask. So based on that data, you have to frame these formulas. Basic formula, they will say that's all. So remaining, you have to apply application related questions. Okay. Now please write down one more question. Calculate. So here two sub questions are there in this one. A, wave number and B, frequency. A, wave number and B, frequency of yellow radiation. Frequency of yellow radiation having wavelength. Frequency of yellow radiation having wavelength 5800 angstrom. Angstrom is given means what is given in the question? Frequency na wavelength aidu. Angstrom means what he given?
Wavelength.
That is important. Nanometer, angstrom, picometers, these are given. What we can conclude? Wavelength is given. If wavelength is given, we can calculate wave number and frequency, na? Isn't it? Students. What is wavelength?
Yes,
A is equal to nu bar is equal to 1 by lambda formula. Clear? Yesterday I told you. Nu bar is equal to 1 by lambda, na? Say yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Convert 5800 angstroms into meters.
Again, 10 raised to minus 10.
Very good. 1 angstrom is equal to 10 power minus 10 meters, na? So that's why 5800 angstroms means 5800 into 10 power minus 10 meters. Very good. Okay, nu bar is equal to 1 by 5800 into 10 power minus 10 meters. You simplify whatever, nu bar is equal to how much you will get? In scientific notation, you say it is minus 10, plus 10. 1 by 5800, how much? scientific notation. I want answer in scientific notation. Please take 30 seconds time, no problem. Please report your answer. Quick. Scientific notation, I want answer. Minu.
Sir, 5.8 into 10 power 7.
Enna ma?
Sir, 5.8 into 10 power 7.
Wrong.
1.72 into 10 power 6.
1.724 into 10 power 6. 72
into 10 power 6.
Unit. Very good. 1.72 into 10 power 6. Absolutely correct. Murali, Apurva, Punit, Yurella. Okay, now. You need to meter inverse, thane. Not meter. Minu. This is meter. You need to meter inverse. 1.72 into 10 power 6 meter inverse. The answer. Next. Second one, Yanama. Frequency. Nu is equal to formula c by lambda. So here I am taking velocity of light in meters, ma. That is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Here wavelength same. 5800 into 10 power minus 10 meter. Meter cancel. Nu is equal to what you get. Second inverse answer, no problem. What is the answer? Scientific notation, okay. Scientific notation I want. Answering scientific notation. 5.17 into 10 power 14. 5.17 into 10 power 14. Second inverse. What is the another unit of frequency, students?
Hertz.
5.17 into 10 power 14, second inverse. Very good. It's completed, ma'am. Next, last problem. So these all problems you have in your material also. How many members did problems from material? Students. How many you done?
So can you move Anisha? A bit?
Yes.
Can you move a bit?
11 to 29 problems.
Level 1 up to model, that is atomic model, easy. All questions are easy.
Yes, sir. Sir, one doubt, sir. E by M, sir, ratio for protein. Sir, proton.
Proton.
Yes, sir. Sir, that one only doubt.
Okay, I will solve. You please round up such type of questions, sir. I will discuss in the class. Okay, na?
Right, sir.
Sir, totally, I don't want to say to you, you solve all. How many are possible? At least you have to do that questions. Remaining questions in level 1 or level 2, please round up that questions that we will discuss. Actually, please remember, proton is 1837 times greater than electron. So if you get any idea, you please solve that. Proton is how many times greater than electron? 1837 times. 1837 times greater than electron. So, Andre, electron weight is 1 by 1837 times of proton. Proton charge is to mass is to the module. Charge is same, 1.602 into 10 power minus 19. Mass of proton 1.675672 into 10 power minus 31 kg. Okay, na? The module. Please try, otherwise, I will solve. Puneet, you have to complete either. How many completed you, Puneet? Bravara not completed, I think. Both level 1 and level 2. Both level 1 and level 2. How many doubt? Minu, how many questions I have doubt?
Question doubt is there.
One
doubt.
Only?
One question doubt, sir.
Only one question, huh?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay, let me solve. Students, please solve your own. Syllabus already I told, na? Some basic concepts of chemistry, subjective as well as objective. Okay. Next, please write down last problem. The Vivid Bharati station of Vivid Bharati, you know, Prasar Bharati radio. The Vivid Bharati station,
yes,
of the Vivid Bharati station of All India Radio Delhi. AIR means what? All India Radio Delhi broadcast.
Sir, can you repeat the question, sir? Can you repeat that, sir?
The Vivid Bharati station of All India Radio Delhi broadcasts on a frequency of 1368 kilohertz. 1368 kilohertz. So he given hertz means which characteristic of wave is given?
Frequency.
Frequency. Very good. 1368 kilohertz. Full stop. Calculate the wavelength of electromagnetic radiation. Calculate the wavelength of electromagnetic radiation emitted by transmitter. Calculate the wavelength of electromagnetic radiation emitted by transmitter. Full stop. Which part of the electromagnetic spectrum? Full stop. Which part of the electromagnetic spectrum which part of the electromagnetic spectrum does it belong to? Okay, now this is the question. A second part is not necessary for you, that is I will say easily. First, well, what we have to do, ma? Calculate the wavelength of transmitter of frequency 1368 kilohertz. Students, this is nu. Nu is given. So nu is equal to, I will write like this, 1368 into 10 power 3 hertz. Will you accept? Yes,
yes, sir.
You have to accept. Why? Because in first unit, what we discussed, multiples and their significances, na? Digit and their multiples. Kilo means what we will write? 10 power 3. Mega means? Giga means?
10 power 9. 10
power 9.
10 power 12. Tera. So many multiples we have, na? So that's why instead of A, I will write 10 power 3 hertz. That's all. Both are same. Next. Nu is equal to C by lambda. Lambda is equal to formula C by nu. So lambda is equal to C value, please take it meters. D into 10 power 8 meter per second. Next, this is what now? 1368 into 10 power 3 hertz. You see, this Hartzell second inverse cancel up. Students, Hartzell is nothing but second inverse only, na? Second inverse is second inverse. Cancel. Please solve. What is the answer? In scientific notation, I got it. Two point one nine into 10^3, na? Two, na? Yes. 2.19 into
10^3.
Three, na?
The 2.19 10 to the power of 2.
10^2. Okay. Lambda is equal to. Still, I don't want these two powers. What we can do now? 2.19 into 100 thane. Andre ishtam. 219. So 219 meters. So under question is what now? Question is belongs to which radiation, sir? It is belongs to broadcasting means. Nothing but we have different broadcastings. TV broadcasting, that is a satellite. Next, radio broadcasting. This is belongs to radio wave. This is belongs to radio wave. So in question only it is there, na? It belongs to All India Radio Delhi. So that's why the radiation is belongs to. Please write conclusion, final conclusion. The radiation is belongs to radio waves. The wavelength of radiation is belongs to radio waves. Radiation is belongs to radio waves. So these are the some important problems related to wavelength, frequency and wave number. So you may get so many questions in your material related to wavelength, frequency, wave number. Later you solve, not now. Next side heading one, electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic spectrum. See, we have different waves or different electromagnetic waves. What are the different electromagnetic waves? Gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, IR waves, microwaves, radio waves, long radio waves, cosmic rays. These are the different electromagnetic radiations or these are the different electromagnetic waves. So the arrangement of these different electromagnetic radiations in increasing order of their wavelengths or decreasing order of frequencies is called electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, no? Electromagnetic spectrum means what? Spectrum is nothing but arrangement of different waves in the order of increasing order of their wavelength or decreasing order of their frequencies is called electromagnetic spectrum. So what is the common factor in this electromagnetic spectrum? We have different waves, na? These different waves have same velocity. These different waves have same velocity. So velocity, so that's why we wrote what? 3 × 10^8 meter per second or 3 × 10^10 centimeter per second. So what is the common factor in all waves? Velocity is the same. Velocity is constant for all these waves. Energy and remaining factors are different. Okay, na? So please write down. The arrangement of different the arrangement of different electromagnetic radiations. The arrangement of different electromagnetic radiations. In increasing order of their wavelengths, in increasing order of their wavelengths, increasing order of their wavelengths, or decreasing order of their frequencies, increasing order of wavelengths, or decreasing order of their frequencies. Decreasing order of their frequencies is known as electromagnetic spectrum. Is known as electromagnetic spectrum.
So can you explain so why velocities of these waves are same?
These all are waves, na. Waves velocity is constant. Speed is constant. You take any one of the wavelength or frequency. What is the formula? Nu is equal to c by lambda, na. Increasing wavelength or decreasing frequency of any one. You take wavelength or frequency of any one wave. So you please take calculation of c. That is c is equal to question mark. You please check what is the c value you are getting. Take some data, wavelength and frequency of some other radiations. Say for example, the frequency of radio waves is 3168 into 10 power 3, 3168 into 10 power 3 hertz. 3 point. Speed of sound waves is different. Sound waves requires medium. Sound waves requires medium. But electromagnetic radiations does not require any medium. Clear? So is a sound produces in vacuum? No. I think you have in your lower classes Bell jar experiment. Do you have Bell jar experiment?
Yes, sir.
What is the main thing of Bell jar experiment?
Sound cannot travel in vacuum.
Sound cannot transmitted in vacuum. That is the meaning of that Bell jar experiment. Okay, na?
Sir, but speed of this red waves and sir, in spectrum, sir, it will vary.
Speed of sound waves, speed of electromagnetic radiations is different. Speed of electromagnetic radiations is equal to speed of light.
Okay, sir.
You take some values, ma. Wavelength 219 meters. Okay, na? Frequency 3168 into 10 power 3 hertz. What is the C value you will get? C value is fixed you will get. Okay, na?
3 to 10 to the power 8 only.
3, that only. Whatever increasing frequency or decreasing wavelength you will take, you will get 3 value. That is C value is that only. That's all.
Okay, so, sir. Thank you, sir.
Velocity of waves is constant. But the energy remaining all are different. Okay, na?
Yes.
What I told, ma? Electromagnetic radiations they have. What I wrote? Electromagnetic radiations they have equal velocities. Okay, na? Please remember that these electromagnetic radiations in order, ma. I will write. Cosmic rays
gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, IR rays, microwaves, radio waves. So here are two waves, FM, AM. Next is long radio waves. Here, this is wavelength is increases, means cosmic rays have less wavelength. Okay, which rays have highest wavelength? Long radio waves have highest wavelength. Okay, na? Next. Cosmic rays have highest frequency. Long radio waves have lowest frequency. What is IR one? IR means what?
Infrared radiation.
Infrared. Okay. UV? Ultraviolet rays.
Ultraviolet rays.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is that FM and AM, sir? Radio waves. That, sir, in radio waves, FM and AM.
FM, you know FM? Red FM, Radio Mirchi, Radio City. FM means frequency module. Frequency module. AM means alternative module.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, na? Long radio waves means there you will get TV, satellite rays, that all. So different dish channels you have now. Dish TV, Videocon DTH, Airtel DTH, different. So their frequency setup is very, very important. Okay, na? They have different frequencies, but the range is in this range only, here to here. So that's why these are called waves, not rays. These are called rays. Okay, na? Up to here only rays, remaining are waves.
So okay, that's vis rays, V-I-S, vis rays.
Yes, yes.
So vis rays.
Vis rays, visible rays, visible rays.
Visible rays,
visible spectrum.
Cosmic rays, what's that, sir?
Huh?
Sir, after cosmic rays.
Gamma rays, gamma.
Yes, sir.
Gamma symbol, alpha, beta, gamma, delta, gamma. See, these cosmic rays, gamma rays, X-rays used in medicine. Treatment of, consume the, that is, destroy the tumors, you know, tumors. Human body tumors will be now, that tumors they can destroy by passing through gamma rays and the cosmic rays. So these gamma rays and the cosmic rays, where you will get from other substances, okay, na? With a high frequency, their velocity, their wavelength is lesser, frequency is very high, okay, na? Radioactive substances, you know, radioactive substances are mainly used in water. Treatment of thyroid disorder.
Yeah.
Okay, na?
Cancer.
Cancer treatment is all. Okay,
sir, which rays can kill humans, sir? Sir, which rays can kill humans, sir?
Tumors,
sir? Sir, human.
Gamma rays, cosmic rays.
So they can kill the human?
No. Tumors, sir. kill
sir,
the
they harm the
so, so many rays are there. Rays. What happened if the wavelength temperature? What is the relation wavelength temperature? Inversely proportional. That means if you raise the temperature more and more, the frequency is also increases. Some other rays we have na.
Okay, sir.
Okay, na. Their frequency is very very high. Which rays kills you are asking? I don't know exactly. Okay, na. But also rays we have.
Gamma rays, right, sir? Because it's quite penetrating and. Gamma rays, right, sir? It can kill humans.
Gamma rays. So many. Even though you see UV rays are also danger. Skin cancer will get due to depletion of ozone layer. So that's why if you imagine UV rays are danger, automatically X rays, gamma rays, cosmic rays are also danger. X rays are taking photography from the part of the body. That to lesser frequency, not higher frequency. Okay, na? The particular part only na they apply for X rays. So do you know why X rays are taken in dark room? Means this is the secret, not the human body is a secret. Clear? So to avoid the direct contact with other persons, X rays they are maintained in some separate secret dark room. Sensitive reactions. Okay, na? So that's why they did like that.
Sir, which waves are used in mobile phones, sir?
Mobile rays is there. Radio waves or long radio waves? Mobile rays.
Okay, sir.
So that's why.
Sir, which rays are?
That's why people will say if frequency is increases, danger levels also increases.
Sir, which rays are harmful, sir, for humans?
Up to here, IR rays, visible rays, UV rays, gamma rays, X rays. These are danger. These are somewhat less danger. Microwaves. So microwaves that are used in solar. You know solar. Solar heating.
Sir, it's used in TV, sir. Television also, no, sir. Microwaves.
Microwaves are used in microwave, right, sir?
Yes, sir. Microwaves. Next, solar waves. Solar also comes in this part only. IR rays, microwaves only. Solar rays. Heating of solars. Solar panels are there, na? Where big solar park is there in Karnataka?
Sir, Pavagada, sir.
You are in Tumkur district. You are not saying about the big solar park in Asia. Pavagada. Pavagada, Tumkur district only, na? Or you are separating or you are mixing with Andhra?
No.
Pavagada is Karnataka. Madakeshira is Andhra. Alva?
Yes, sir.
Next month. Please remember. Visible rays wavelength ma 380 nanometers to 750 nanometers ma. What is the wavelength of visible rays? Please write that point, that's all. Why? Because visible rays only we can observe, remaining we cannot observe. So that's why that frequency we have to remember. Frequency or wavelength. So what is the wavelength range for visible rays? 380 nanometers to 750 nanometers. 380 nanometers to 750 nanometers.
Sir, should we know the wavelength and frequencies of these rays, sir?
Ma?
Sir, should we know the frequencies and wavelength of these rays?
Should be?
Frequency and wavelength should be known to us about these rays, sir.
Can't hear properly. These rays?
Sir, should we know these frequencies of these rays? Should we learn about these frequencies? I'm asking about this, sir.
Value is not required. Only visible rays wavelengths required. That's all. Okay, na?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Remaining not required.
So that, that is the 10 power minus 6 something. 10 power minus 6. This is the 10 power positive values you will get. So that's why non-inter required. This is important. Only this is the place wavelength is important. 380 to 750 nanometers or 400 to 700 nanometers. Generally, we will take. Okay, na? Next. Side heading one, black body radiations. Students, do you know what is a black body and black body radiations? Any idea?
No, sir.
In your lower class? First time you are hearing this word, black body?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay.
Yes, sir.
Please write down my side. Black body radiations. Side heading. First of all, what is a black body? Okay, na? And which type of objects or which type of object is act as a black body? And what are black body radiations? Now we will discuss. First of all, what is black body? Okay, na? Please remember, ma. The perfect absorber, absorption, and perfect emitter of all types of radiations is called black body. What is black body? Black body is a perfect absorber and perfect emitter of all types of radiations is called black body. Radiations of black body are called black body radiations. Whatever it may be, absorbed radiations or released radiations of black body are called black body radiations. Next, which type of objects are act as a black body? Actually, black body is an ideal body, means no object cannot works as like a, no 100% works like a black body. But a hollow sphere inside coated with platinum block, hollow sphere like this. Hollow sphere inside coated with the platinum black and a small hole in its wall, small hole in its wall act as a nearly black body, nearly black body. So the radiations of black body are called black body radiations. Now what is the main theme of this black body radiation? Okay, now black body radiation is mainly used to know the particle nature of object. Actually, object is associated with two natures. Any accelerated object, if you take, it is associated, say for example, electron. Electron is associated with two radiations. One is a wave nature. Wave nature, just now we discussed. Another one is a particle nature. So to explain particle nature of object, we have to know about black body radiations. We have to know about black body radiations. Clear, students? So every substance is associated with two types of natures. One is wave nature, another one is particle nature. So wave nature is to work complete aayitu, electromagnetic radiation, that is explains wave nature. Particle nature, to understand better, we have to know little bit about black body radiations. So in detail you will get in physics black body radiations and their graphs. So now how it is related to particle nature of electromagnetic radiation, that all we will discuss in physics second PUC. Just we have what is black body, what are black body radiations, and Planck's quantum theory we have in our syllabus. Okay, na? Now what is black body, students? Definition is
a perfect absorber and emitter. A perfect absorber and emitter.
observer and
observer and emitter of all types of radiation.
Very good. What is black body radiation?
Radiation of black body is called to be the
radiation of black body. Radiation means in the sense
radiation
either
black body.
Black body radiation or emitted radiation. That is called black body radiation. So which is act as black body? Nearly black body?
Halosphere coated with aluminium.
Halosphere with a platinum.
Coated where? Inside or outside?
Inside. Platinum.
A halosphere inside coated with platinum black and has a small hole in its wall. Act as a nearly black body. Okay, na? So this is about black body radiations. Please write down first. The ideal body. Which emits and absorbs. An ideal body which emits and absorbs all types of radiations. Which emits and absorbs all types of radiations is called black body. The radiations of black body. The radiations of black body are called black body radiations. The radiations of black body are called black body radiations. Next ma. Next line. A hollow sphere. A hollow. H-O-L-L-O-W. Hollow means empty. Empty space inside. If you take a tennis ball, if you cut it into two pieces, inside or empty space is there like that. Hollow means empty space. A hollow sphere inside. Coated with inside coated with platinum black inside coated with platinum black, which has a small hole in its wall. Which has a small hole in its wall. In its wall. Act as a near black body. As a near black body. Simon, you please observe this graph related to black body radiations. Respect to black body only. Intensity of radiation on one axis, wavelength on another axis. Okay? Here, at a given temperature, I am taking, not at a particular temperature, at a given temperature. Say, for example, this is a peak of a curve at a given temperature. This is P1.
at 1000 Kelvin. This is the T2. This is the T3. This is the T3. So this is the lambda 1. This is the lambda 2. This is the lambda 3. So, what information we will get from this graph? So, as the temperature increases, this is at a particular temperature. What happens at a particular temperature? The intensity of radiation increases to maximum and then decreases, isn't it? Intensity of radiation increases to maximum. This is maximum, means peak I am taking. Increases to maximum and then decreases at a particular temperature. As the temperature raises, what happens? Say for example, take a T2, temperature raises. If you take a temperature till 2000 Kelvin, at the peak, which has the highest intensity, T1 or T2, please say from the graph. Clear what I am asking? This is a peak of first curve at a temperature T1. That is lambda 1 wavelength. Next, this is the second peak, this is third peak. I am asking which has the highest intensity. If you take T1 and T2, not I am not talking about the T3, T1 and T2, which has the highest intensity of radiation?
T2.
It increases to 5, 6, 7, 10, like that. Very good. T2 has the highest intensity. At a peak, which has the lowest wavelength? At a peak, which has the lowest wavelength? Same, very good. T2 only. This is lambda 1. No? This is lambda 2. Which is the lowest wavelength? Lambda 2 only. No? Lambda 2 only has the lowest wavelength. Next, at a temperature T1 or T2 degree, which has the highest intensity? T3 has the highest intensity.
T3.
Which has the lowest wavelength? T3. T3 only has the lowest wavelength. That is lambda 3. So, by using this graph of black body radiations, what we can conclude, students? What we can conclude?
Intensity is inversely proportional to temperature.
Intensity inversely proportional to temperature. Wavelength inversely proportional to temperature.
Wavelength inversely proportional to temperature.
Intensity is directly proportional to temperature, but wavelength is inversely proportional to temperature. Clear? Any doubts in this? Please check once. So, from this graph, what you have to remember, the key point is intensity is directly proportional to temperature, but inversely proportional to wavelength. Right? Temperature is directly proportional to intensity. As the temperature is increases, intensity increases. But wavelength, what happened? Wavelength decreases only, no? So that's why wavelength temperature inversely proportional. Wavelength temperature inversely proportional. Okay, no? So this is about graphical representation of black body radiations. Next, please remember, the black body radiations we can explain by using Planck's quantum theory. Please remember the postulates of Planck's quantum theory we have listed. I will explain the postulates, easy postulates only. So in these postulates, you have to remember one formula. That's all. First of all, black body radiations uses what? To explain which nature of particle. Sorry, which nature of object?
Particle.
That is important. That's all. Okay, no? I only told you particle. See, Planck's quantum theory. First postulate, according to Planck's quantum theory, energy absorbed or radiated, energy absorbed or radiated discontinuously in the form of small packets of energy, discontinuously in the form of small packets of energy. The small packets of energy is called quantum. The small packets of energy. Here, what I told, black body means what I told.
Say. Sir, can you repeat it, sir?
Yes, yes. Please listen. We observer and emitter. See here, black body radiations we can successfully explain by using Planck's quantum theory. According to Planck's quantum theory, the substance means black body. The substance which absorbs or radiates energy discontinuously in the form of small packets of energy. How black body absorbs or radiates energy? Radiates energy continuously or discontinuously?
Discontinuously
in the form of small packets of energy. For this best example, you see, you are boiling water, ma. So temperature, 10 degrees temperature is there for your water. Your intention is to boil the water to up to 100 degrees centigrade. So whenever you keep that 10 degrees centigrade water on a gas stove, at a time the temperature is raised to 100 degrees centigrade for that water. At a time the temperature is raises for that water. No. That means it is not a continuous, it is a discontinuously takes place. Discontinuously means after 5 minutes while you are boiling, it reaches to 20 degrees. After 5 minutes, 140 degrees. After 5 minutes, 150 degrees. That means level to level, as the temperature is increases, water boiling capacity is also increases. Discontinuously, not at a time. Na. Similarly, while you are cooling hot water, hot coffee, it is not possible to drink. Very hot coffee, I am telling. So, what we have to do? We have to wait for some instant time. We have to wait for some time. Why? Because is a hot coffee at a time, if you kept on a table, converted into 10 degrees centigrade? No. That means, which radiates or absorbs energy discontinuously. Discontinuously means it is loses energy. Hot coffee if you take, it loses energy. Boiling of water means what we can say? Absorption of energy only. If you supply energy, boiling of water takes place. That is, either absorption or release of energy discontinuously takes place in the form of small packets. Okay, na? The small packets of energy, according to this Planck's quantum theory, is called quantum. What is quantum? The small packets of energy is called what? Quantum. So the energy of this quantum is directly proportional to its frequency. The energy of quantum is directly proportional to what? Its frequency. Energy of quantum is directly proportional to its frequency. That is, here I am writing. E proportional to E. So E is equal to, instead of proportional D, we can write H E. What is the H mark? H is called here Planck's constant. Planck's constant. Nu is equal to frequency of radiation. E is equal to energy. Okay. What is the modified formula for this, students? Can I say E is equal to H C by lambda? Can we write, students? Yeah, can write. Nu means what? Nu means formula. I am asking. Nu is equal to C by lambda only, na? So instead of nu, I wrote C by lambda. So that's why E is equal to H C by lambda. Okay. So this formula you have to, remember. Okay. So this is about Planck's quantum theory. So I repeat, Planck's quantum theory, first postulate, the substance absorbs or radiates energy discontinuously in the form of small packets. That's the first point. Second point, the small packets of energy is called what? Quantum. That is the second point. Next, third point. The energy of this quantum is directly proportional to frequency of radiation. Okay, no? This is the formula. E proportional to mu r is equal to hm. These are the terms. Okay. Will you write your what?
Yes, again, sir. The last point. Directly proportional to them.
The energy of quantum is directly proportional to frequency. Frequency of radiation. Okay, no? Tomorrow I will go, no problem. Don't worry about it. Okay, no? Please remember the formula for me. That's all. Okay, students. Thank you. Thank you very much.